Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are all fine and safe at home. I am happy to meet you all. This is Karthikeyan, economics teacher from Bharatha Star Matriculation Air Secondary School, Arakkonam. Today we are going to see an excellent topic from the second chapter of 11th economics, namely consumption analysis. So in economics, basically the three processes are very important, namely production, second one is distribution, and third one is consumption. Yes, generally in economics, these are the three important things: production, distribution and consumption. Let us see what is the production means. Converting of raw material into a finished goods, it is the production, and then the finished goods are supplied to the concerned market, that is called as distribution. And after the distribution to the marketing places, the consumers who are consuming the goods, which means buying the goods and consuming the goods or using the goods, is called as consumption. So here, among these three processes, the consumption is very, very important, and it is the basic economic activity for society. Here, the consumption is an essential economic activity. If we more consumption is occur in a society, means there will be a more production and there will be a more distribution. And what is consumption means? As I mentioned, consumption means usage of the goods, consuming the goods, the consumer who buying the goods and they achieve a satisfaction. Okay, that is called as consumption. If a consumer buy a pen for 10 rupees, if he is satisfying for the 10 rupees while using the goods, that is called as consumption. Okay, here it gives a satisfaction to the consumer who owned the goods. So as I mentioned, consumption is the essential economic activity and it is important for the economic activity. And as I said, the goods and services, okay, the goods and services is involved in the production process, and the goods and services are used by the consumer after buying the goods or owned the goods. And here the uses of goods and service for satisfying our wants. Each and every human being or each and every consumer in the society have many wants. To satisfying their wants, the production was done, and after the production, the distribution is done, and after buying the goods by each and every consumer, they have achieved a satisfaction while using that consumer, I mean goods and services. That is called as want satisfying power. Simply we can say economics is nothing but want satisfying power of a consumer. And consumption is beginning of, as I mentioned, it is the beginning of all the economic activity. If the more consumption occur in the society, means there is a more production as well as more distribution occur. Yes, human wants. Each and every person needs a something in the society. So each and every one have a wants, and each and every wants are differ from each other. Okay, all the wants are not limited. So each and every person have a unlimited wants. So to achieve their wants or to achieve the satisfying power, see, in ordinary language we can say desire and want are same. Desire, asai. Okay, manushanukku ellarkume aasa irukku, aasa illada manushu yaarume kediyadu. So each and every single person have a desire, and in commonly we can say desire and want are same. But in economics, the same word giving a different meaning, which means human behavior to buy and consume the goods. So if I am desire for any goods, means I need to buy the goods and I using the goods, and then later I attain the satisfaction. So that is what they mention, consumption. Generally human wants are same, when commonly desire and wants are same, but in economics it is a want satisfying power, and it depends upon the behavior of each and every consumer while buying and using the goods. And yes, another important topic, the characteristics of human wants. So what are the characteristics of human wants? See, wants are unlimited, but we have only limited amount of resources. Yeah.
resources.
So we have only limited amount of resources to achieve the unlimited wants of a human being. So that's why the first important characteristics of wants are they are unlimited. Okay. And next one, wants become habits. Yes, wants become each and every person. And for example, in the morning, our parent used to read the newspaper. First day he read the newspaper, second day he read the newspaper, third day he read the newspaper, and finally it become a habit. So in that situation, the human being, the nature of the human being is become a habit. So every single day the routine work become the habits, and first day the newspaper is become a want, and later it was regularly used, it will become a habit. So paakla morning la ஒரு சில நியூஸ் பேப்பர் படித்தா தான் உங்களுக்கு என்ன ஆகுனாக்கா த டே வில் பி ஸ்பெஷல் டே. லைக் வைஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் த வாண்ட் பிகம் ஹேபிட் வைல் ரெகுலர்லி யூஸிங் ஆர் ரெகுலர்லி கன்சியூமிங். தட் இஸ் த செகண்ட் கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக்ஸ் ஆஃப் வாண்ட்ஸ். தட் இஸ் த வாண்ட்ஸ் பிகம் ஹேபிட்ஸ். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், வாண்ட்ஸ் பிகம் சாட்டியபிள். வாண்ட்ஸ் பிகம் சாட்டியபிள் மீன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் நாட் இட் இஸ் நாட் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபைட் அட் த மூமெண்ட். திடீர்னு மூமெண்ட்டில் எந்த ஒரு மூமெண்ட்லேயும் சாட்டிஸ்ஃபை ஆகிட மாட்டாங்க. தட் இஸ் சாட்டியபிள். இட் இஸ் சேஞ்சிங், changing, always changing. Okay, hungry person, if I am hungry means I can take a food, and after that again I'll get hungry. That is called as satiable. It is not satisfying at the moment, it is changing always. And next one, wants are alternative. Yes, if I become hungry, I can have a idli. Okay sir, I don't want a idli means I have an alternative, I can go for dosa. Otherwise, I can go for another anything. So likewise, so my want is an alternative. If I don't like a idli means, I can go for a dosa, I can go for a chapati, I can go for puri, whatever. So whatever I want, it can be alternative. Not like a same thing I can consume. I have an alternative. Yes, here wants are competitive. Why wants are competitive? So as I mentioned, human wants are not limited. They are an enormous thing. And here, but we have to decide which is an urgent want, which is an most urgent want, which is not a most urgent want. We have to decide. First time I'm getting salary from my company, I planned to spend the money for the to give the treat for the friends. But suddenly my parents or my father, who was affected health wise, so that time I have to decide the money should be spent for what want. Okay, this is called as competitive. Okay, so I have to decide which is the most urgent want and which is not the most urgent want, which means I can easily make a plan to spend the first month's salary to my parents' health. So that is why we can say wants are competitive, and we have to decide which is the most urgent want and then not most urgent want. Okay, and next one, wants are complementary. For example, we can have a ink pen. What is the necessary for ink pen? Only ink. So that's why we say the ink pen need only a ink. There is no alternative here. Okay, likewise the diesel engine. Okay, the petrol engine, it have only the complementary of the diesel only, the petrol only. The engine what does needs, that is called as complementary. Here ink pen need only ink, there is no alternative for them. Likewise the diesel engine need a diesel only as a fuel, and petrol engine need a petrol as a fuel. So there is no alternative, and that is what called complementary to each other. So ink pen is complementary to ink, and diesel engine is complementary to diesel, and petrol engine is complementary to petrol. And next one, wants are recurring. As I mentioned in the previous slide, recurring means again and again. Okay, recurring means again and again. Okay, again and again means if I get angry means I can take a food. Again I get angry, again and I take the food, again I get angry means again I take the food. So this is called as recurring, again and again. So I am not satisfied with the one time of food taking. Okay. So these are the characteristics of wants. Wants are competitive, complementary to each other, and recurring, again and again. Yes. Classification of the goods. I hope you know what are the goods means. The raw material are converted into a finished goods. Okay. Production. The process is called as production. Converting raw material. So converting raw material into a finished goods. Okay, we can make a usage of the raw material into a usable goods. Raw material into a finished goods. Which means nothing but converting the raw material into a usable goods. We can use the goods by obtaining or making a process. Okay, that is called as goods. And here we can classify the goods into three: necessary goods, comfortable goods, and luxury goods. So these are the basic things. I mean, necessary is very important, and comfortable and luxurious. Let us see what are the meaning of the three kinds of these goods. Yes, necessary goods. It is very essential for lead our life. Without this thing, as I mentioned, it is indispensable. It cannot be separate from our life. Without these goods, we cannot live. See, food, yes, food, cloth, and shelter. Without these things, we cannot live. So this is the basic goods, also called as basic goods. And here, food, shelter, and cloth. Water, it is also very essential for our daily life. But nowadays, water, shelter, cloth, food, everything is basic needs. As I mentioned, it is indispensable from our life. It cannot be divided from our life. Without these goods, we cannot live. So these are the basic things. Even we can, all the set of people in the society depend upon these goods. Whether you are a rich, poor, middle class family, whatever you are, without these goods, we cannot live. Such a kind of goods are called as necessary goods. Food, cloth, and shelter. And another one, next thing is, yes, comfortable goods. Comfortable goods are the goods which make our regular or routine life very easier and more comfortable. Such a kind of goods are called as comfortable goods. We can simply say all the electronical goods: washing machine, fridge, television, fan, tube light. All these goods are make our life more easier and more comfortable. Such a quality possessed by these goods called as comfortable goods. Simply, we can easily remember the word comfort. The life which was comfortable by these goods is called as comfortable goods. Okay. And next one is luxurious goods. And these are the goods mostly used by the high class people in the society, very wealthy people, to show their living standard. See, na evlo panakaram pathiya appdin kaatradhukaga vechiruka goods dhaan solranaga luxurious goods. The goods which is showing their living standard. Okay, they showing that we are the higher class people in the society. Such a goods are called as luxurious goods, but it is not essential for our daily routine life, but it is somewhat showing their standard of living. Standard of living high in the society. So these goods showing that the living standard as a high in the society. Mostly the wealthy people used to consume these kind of goods, and hence we call them as a luxurious goods. Okay. Okay, I have attached the study material, question bank, and self-assessment along with this session, and please kindly go through that for your further studies. I hope this session will be helpful for you. Thank you. Thanks a lot.